Okay, let's continue on with question number three here. Question number three, they're asking me to estimate the square root of 89 to the nearest hundredth. Now, this is like that problem we did earlier with the calculation, so this is one I said earlier that we need to practice some more. If you look at your textbook on page 187, there's a really good explanation here of what we did once again. If you had a hard time following it or didn't quite see all the steps, they're actually written out what the steps are here so we can follow along. So again, we're going to do like we did in question number one, though, and start off by finding those surrounding square roots, also the same thing we did in question number two there. As you can see, we've got 89. Well, we know some numbers that are going to work for us around 89. We know that the square root of 81 is 9. That's a known. The square root of 100 is 10. Obviously, square root of 89 is going to fit in between these two guys. So my answer here is somewhere between 9 and 10. We know my answer isn't going to start with 10 because if it starts with 10, it's past 100. All right, well, it's not past 100, obviously, because it's only 89. So it's going to have to be something that starts off with a 9. So that's going to be the start of my answer. And as you can see, since that's already written, you know that that actually turns out to be factual. So what they do then there is they say in step 2, which again, you can follow along on page 187, is they ask us to find the difference between the given number, the number that's in the problem, 89, and the lower perfect square that's surrounded, which was 81. Well, 89 minus 81 is going to change into an 8. And then what they say is to find the difference between the greater perfect square and the lower perfect square. So to find the difference between here, what is 181, which is of course going to be 19. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take and divide those. You're going to write that as a ratio, which means write that as a fraction, really. And then go ahead and divide those out. Well, when you take 8 and divide it by 19, 8 divided by 19 is 0.42105263. And since the directions are asking me to go to the nearest hundredth, we only have to go 2 after the decimal, 0.42. And remember, all we do is we stick that on the answer we already have, the 9, and that's how we come up with 9.42. In the last one here, they're asking me to use a calculator to find the square root of 800. Square root of 800 on a calculator, again, you can use the square root key or you can use the exponent key and use the 0.5 power, and that's going to be 28.28427125. Again, rounded to the nearest tenth, one after the decimal is 28.3.